they were underestimating what happened today. You know? And they went ahead. They said, the hell with that. But they didn't realize, he didn't realize. It was a blow for him, right in his face. What happened today? They didn't expect that, and I know. And it may sound like, okay, things are just gonna stay the same, but that's working in his mind. He's not gonna sleep tonight, okay? And he's not gonna sleep for the coming months, because I think this is not finished.
That's right.
I suggest not only the website, but blogs in within the websites promoting all kinds of activities to remind the students, the faculty, the staff, the citizens, okay? And to do outreach to the other campuses. And as soon as the semester, the fall semester starts, get it on. I mean, with emotion, with force. Show your anger, because this is a blow to all of the community that are against this man and what he represents. I think you people need a little bit of more emotion. Okay? Acting, the theater department, the musicians, everybody that wants an act, everybody that put an installation, anything. Little by little, a little bit here, a little bit there, in that campus, in business, in all the faculties, to remind each one of the professors, the staff, everybody, that the fight is still on. Because that degree has to come back to the university. That man has to return that honorary degree.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay? He has to. So in order to do that, because it's very easy, you people had a lot on your shoulders, the students of everybody. So it's easy to forget, and we're tired, maybe we won't be able. No, now it's the time to prepare. So in August, not September, in August already, with the people getting registered, the new people registering, hit them. Hit them immediately. Remind them, if you won't want this, you have to come to this side and show it. Show your anger, show your emotions, and show your disgust, because that's the only way. That degree has to come back to UMass for the respect of each one of the community of Amherst, of Massachusetts, University of Massachusetts, and the people in this country that are against this terrible situation and the takeover of democracy. I suggest keep going. I hope to survive my process. I have a very personal process. And if I survive, I'll be here. I'm trying to get to Holyoke and get to the people, which are the people from my country, what they forgot there from there. And just get emotional. Just keep that, you don't have to be aggressive to show your anger. There are many ways to show in anger, but you have to be a little more emotional. So people can really believe in you a little bit, you know, more passionate about what you do. Thank you.
When I'm officially going to have a degree, University of Massachusetts has chosen to honor another criminal, Michael James Smith, who's the chairperson of Edo Corporation, a company whose two largest customers are the Israeli Defense Forces and the United States Air Force. He makes bomb racks and weapons delivery systems. So I'm not going to my graduation tomorrow, so I'll take one tonight. And, you know, I guess I just wanted to reiterate a couple of things that everyone else has said about just the amazing display of solidarity and and of decency that I'm taking away. I hope everyone else is going to take away from this experience, that ordinary people like us, students, community members, faculty and staff, a number of unions in the state and elsewhere from Vermont, around the country actually, signed on to our petition and wrote letters of solidarity for this cause. And to me, you know, that brings out the best in all of us. And I think that, you know, someone had mentioned that, you know, we need to go forward and move on with this. And I think that's absolutely correct. And I think that there are a couple of ways, many different ways that we can do that and remain a successful, and build on our successes and remain a successful movement here at UMass, and in Amherst and in the Pioneer Valley, et cetera. And, you know, one of those things is, I think I mentioned this before, but re-energizing this movement to pressure this hideous university administration to take back its degree that they gave to Carr in the name of the faculty. The faculty technically bestows this degree upon, you know, the honorary recipient, and if, you know, today is any indication, the faculty of the University of Massachusetts at Amherst is not really pleased that they were forced to do this. And, you know, so that's one option. The other option, I think, or another avenue that I think is worth pursuing is, as John said, who left, he has to go back to Vermont, but he mentioned the, you know, the Campus Anti-War Network, and that's a democratic, you know, grassroots organization that sprung up on 50 or 60 campuses around the country now that is able to, or, you know, is in the business of connecting up these various movements. You know, the stuff that happened at Wisconsin and Madison, the stuff that's going on in San Francisco and innumerable other campuses across the country, you know, that's the kind of thing that we need to be able to connect our struggles here at UMass to the larger struggles that are going on around the country. What we do, you know, together, in terms of valuing what people say and valuing ideas and taking each other seriously, you know, that's the model, I think, for change moving, you know, in general and moving forward. And you know, we can counterpose their undemocracy with our real democracy, as Mark pointed out. And I think we've got a good thing going. And I just want to say thanks to people who have turned out today as well, for this. I think this is wonderful. This needs to happen more. And I think that everyone in this room would probably agree with that. And so just thank you very much for coming out. Thank you very much for making this a success. People, come up. If you haven't gotten a degree, and I'm looking at a few UMass students I recognize in the room, so come on up and get a degree and talk about why you're happy to be here.
Okay, my name's TJ. I'm a UMass student. I had an opportunity to go to Ivy League schools after I graduated from community college, and I decided not to go because Ivy League schools they're there to reproduce the elite class, and I don't agree with that. I wanted something that was more countercultural and liberal. And I came up to the Pioneer Valley area, and I was really impressed with what I saw. And so I enrolled at UMass. And then the last two semesters that I've been at UMass, I've been really disappointed with the administration because I've seen how many social controls that they've instituted in the school. I mean, they have plainclothes police officers who dress up like students, going throughout the halls and monitoring completely illegally student activities. I've seen there's 325 cameras on campus. I feel like I'm in prison. And I've really kind of regretted my decision to come to UMass in a lot of ways. But this whole Andy Card thing was kind of like the diuretic icing on a shit cake. I was really like, wow, I can't believe how conservative and it's a big business. And they really don't care about the students there. They really don't. It's like they're just trying to run these people through an assembly line. And I have to say, though, but what I've seen in the last few, like last month with the three different protests that we've had about Andy Card, I've been really proud. And actually, I have to say, I'm really proud to be a UMass student because I've seen this solidarity that I didn't expect to see, especially with the horizontal violence that's encouraged by the administration between groups. You know, hey, young Republicans, fight with the CRC, fight with the RSU, you know. And I don't like that. I think that's keeping the students oppressed and keeping them down. But the solidarity that I've seen when we stormed Whitmore, was just overwhelming to me, and it's made me proud to be a UMass student. That's all I want to say.